Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. I've just done something really crazy. You won't believe it. I bought a Tesla motor on eBay. Let me set the scene. A while ago, I had this wild idea to build my own electric car using parts from crashed and decommissioned vehicles. My first attempt was to make a Toyota Prius gearbox and inverter work as an EV drivetrain. And let me tell you, it was a real hot mess. But I persevered and now I have a better understanding of the open inverter technology I used to control the Toyota inverter. So I thought to myself, why not take it to the next level and build a road legal car that I can drive on a daily basis. And let's be real, nobody wants to drive a GVs. So my original plan was to go for Lexus GS450H inverter and the gearbox as a DIY EV drivetrain with Mazda RX-8 as a donor car. I even ordered a Zombieverter ECU, the electronic board that can control Lexus GS450H inverter.
But fate had other plans.
Just when I thought I had figured it all out, I stumbled upon a listing on eBay where the seller was selling a Tesla Model S front drive motor at a price point that I could not ignore. I mean, the combination of GS450H gearbox and inverter would have cost me about £1,200. But Tesla motor and inverter was for sale at 700. It was like finding a needle in a haystack. I decided to risk it. It does look quite worrisome to go for this one. However, the offer is too good. And in the end of the day, I think eBay is supposed to offer a buyer price guarantee, which I'm hoping will work in this case. And I've also seen, if I look at all the feedback, I also have seen they were selling a Tesla Model X rear-wheel drive unit, which also sold for this price, and they have received a positive feedback in this case. So this is my hope that this is actual genuine seller. So for this reason, I've decided to go and buy it. So let's give it a try. Okay, I'm trying to authenticate this on my mobile. I'm not sure whether this is gonna work. Approved transaction, all done. And I'm just gonna say I'm authorizing the payment. Payment may be going through. Okay, your order is in. Right, well, I feel quite relieved, but at the same time it just feels so scary. I could be wasting £700 on this. Anyway, now we need to wait and see what's going to happen. I have to confess that the price was not the only factor that swayed me towards purchasing Tesla Model S front drive unit. Let's compare some key parameters to figure out which option is really the best for me. Here you go, Tesla versus Lexus battle coming up. First, of course, what is the peak power that could be achieved with each drivetrain? On this one, Lexus wins with 250 kW against 200 kW for Tesla. Dimensions. Tesla is undisputed winner on this one, and we have to take into account that Lexus has two units which will be more difficult to distribute in the car. Weight. Tesla wins this one again with a big margin to spare, 56 kg lighter than Lexus. In this instance, Tesla wins the money game due to the incredible bargain I'm getting with this particular purchase. This brings us to the overall win for Tesla with the final score 3-1. Of course, after I placed an eBay order for the Tesla motor, I needed to get a version of the open inverter board that will work with the Tesla small drive unit. I had downloaded the design files from Damien GitHub and went to GLCPCB to get the board ordered. The design files were uploaded, but had come across a few component shortages. I managed to find substitutes for passives in the end, but I left with two components missing: the PWM driver and transistors that control pre-charge and main contactor. I have to hunt for those somewhere else. I was able to find PWM driver easily from Mauser, but as a power switch IC goes BTS133, I had to resort to going on AliExpress and ordering few of them from there. Despite my love for Mazda RX-8, I've realized that as a result of this purchase, I'll have to change my choice of the donor car. Because I want to make this conversion road legal in the UK and keep the original registration, I'll have to comply with the point system as shown on the screen. One would have to collect 8 points or more to go through a simplified registration process, which will just require an MOT and a letter to DVLA, a vehicle registration authority in UK. In my case, I should have 5 points for chassis, plus 2 points for suspension, and 2 for steering assembly, making it hopefully 9 points in total. This means that I'll have to go for a front-wheel driven car, which brings me to the choice of either Audi TT or Toyota Celica, which I mentioned in one of my previous videos linked in the description below. But at this stage I want to get the drivetrain and the battery sorted out first before I start making any firm plans about donor vehicle purchase. The good news, I already received an email notifying me that the shipment is coming. The bad news, I have to pay custom clearance, input duty and VAT, despite the fact that it's a second-hand item. And it looks like the number of bureaucratic procedures is also increased. I'm trying to ask the company that is doing the delivery to make a clearance for me, but I'm not sure whether this will work out or not. I will report on it as we go along. In the meantime, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you on the next one.